Ordinary Miracles starts right now on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries.
Department 116 of San Diego Superior Court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Catherine A. Woodbury presiding. Please be seated. Come to order.
Good morning, Your Honor.
Morning, Millie.
Docket, please.
Number one on the calendar. Case 327-03-019. Alberta Johnson versus Henry Guzman. Amendment to the child support order and settlement of back payments. Mr. Guzman's gross income is $2,244.63 per month. He lives rent-free in company housing. Child support set last year at $175.50 per week. No payments made since May 15th.
You speak English, Mr. Guzman?
Yes, ma'am.
Then you understand the agreement you made with this court last year?
Yes, ma'am.
Then honor it. Provide for your son or go to jail. Those are your options. Pay the bailiff and you may go.
Next.
06-419. Ralph Weathers versus Mona Harley Weathers.
Yes, we're working on a settlement here, Your Honor.
Counselor, you're either ready to try this case or I rule for the plaintiff. Your choice.
Yes, Your Honor.
517-23-774. Jensen family petitioning the state for termination of foster care.
The Jensens want to return her to the state's custody. They feel She requires a situation more fitting for a young adult.
Mr. Jensen?
Ma'am? Ma'am, my wife and I don't want anyone to think we aren't good citizens or that we don't care.
No one's suggesting anything of the kind.
We've tried our very best with Sally. It's the lying, it's the stealing.
She took our car. Her and her boyfriend. Twice.
Is the girl here? Sally? Is that true? Did you steal the Jensen's car?
I'm stealing if you bring it back.
She took some money also, Your Honor, from my wife's purse, $50.
I didn't take your stupid money.
I can't deal with it anymore. We've tried our best with Sally, but she just doesn't make an effort. She doesn't fit in, you know what I mean?
Very well. The state of California assumes custody of Miss Sally Ann Powell until such time as an appropriate foster family can be secured.
County home's at capacity, Your Honor.
Well, then we'll send her someplace else. Who's here from child welfare?
Not a soul. Pretty much everyone's left.
This is absurd. The child has to go somewhere. The court remands Sally Powell to the juvenile correctional facility. We'll revisit the case in 3 weeks, right after recess.
That's it, ma'am.
Thank you, everyone.
All rise. The court is now in recess.
I don't know. Putting a minor in jail because foster care is full. How ridiculous is that?
It seems like she's got a little petty larceny going on there, too. Well, either way, it's only temporary.
It doesn't matter. 3 weeks in there for a 16-year-old? Mm-mm. Oh, Millie, please file this before you leave.
Sure.
And you better get moving. You have some packing to do. And remember...
I know.
Sunblock.
Yeah. And no more refrigerator magnets. Send me a postcard instead. Enjoy your vacation.
Hey. Hello?
Davis.
Am I interrupting?
Yes. Come on in anyway. What are you doing in my courthouse?
Well, just filed a suit against MedPhase. They screwed up a routine surgery on a 19-year-old woman, top athlete. It is going to cost them.
Let me guess, more than enough to send you and your ladies to Tuscany for the entire summer.
Hey, I'm surprised. Tuscany is unbearable in the summer. I'm thinking about Tahiti or Bora Bora.
How come you and I never made it to Tahiti?
Because you were always too busy with your work. The law is a jealous mistress.
So was your secretary, as I recall.
Are you free Saturday night? I'm throwing a little party over at the grill.
Saturday? Yeah. Yeah, I could probably stop by.
Good. There's somebody I want you to meet.
Good Lord, Davis. You're not setting me up, are you?
No, God, no. I'm getting married. Her name is Monica Tejada. She is a civil attorney. She worked her way through Stanford, 2 years at Justice, and she just got a spot at Johnston & Sloan. I think you'll like her.
She sounds young.
28.
Very young.
All right, I'm sorry. Have I gone about this in the wrong way?
No, 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 not at all. Congratulations. I'd love to come to your party.
Good.
Really? Yes.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, great. Who knows? You may even enjoy yourself, huh?
Yeah. Who knows? I don't mean to be rude, Davis, but I've got a lot of work to do.
Can I give you a little piece of advice?
Why not?
Don't send that girl to jail. I'm sorry. Hey, Sumi, I was eavesdropping. Kids that age are vulnerable. They're so easily swayed. God knows what you're going to be exposing her to there.
I know the dangers as well as you do. But there was no place else to put her. It's the system.
Kay. You are the system.
Davis, I know you mean well, but I've got a lot of work to do.
Which is exactly why we never made it to Tahiti. See you Saturday.
Sorry, I'm late.
You look tired. I understand. The week before recess, you had a million cases. They work you too hard.
I'll survive. Thank you. Speaking of recess,
what's your project this year?
What do you mean?
You always have a project.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Last year, you refinished those old chairs, and the year before that, you stripped your dining room floors, and the year before that, you had bookshelves made for the study.
What is your point, Mother?
How about seeing some actual people?
You wouldn't be referring to you and Dad by any chance, would you?
Hey, this feud you have is silly.
Not a feud, Mom.
I don't care what you call it. It's stupid.
Are we going to eat or argue?
Honey, what your father did was wrong.
Hey, Katie. Now, don't get upset with your mother. She didn't know I was coming. I looked her date book.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Katie, at least help me understand.
You don't understand?
I asked you for a delay in a case. Judges do that all the time.
Not for their fathers, and not for some irrelevant legal matter that could have gotten us both disbarred.
But you haven't heard my side of the story. At least
let me explain.
I don't want
to hear your side. I'll call you, okay?
Okay.
In regard to Anderson versus Craig, both parties have agreed to new terms of custody and waive hearing on the 14th. Oh, and Millie, remind me to follow up with the DA on the Nunez case. We also have the Peterson matter, which...
I'm sorry, Your Honor, I didn't mean to startle you. My name's Miranda. I'm a caseworker with the Child Welfare Office.
It's late. What do you want?
I'd like to talk to you about Sally Powell.
Oh, I see. Now you want to talk. Where were you 3 hours ago?
I apologize for that.
Apologize to Sally, not me. She's in jail because of you.
It's not entirely my fault. My department is on overload right now. We're understaffed.
Oh, I see. Well, tell me this. What kind of foster family rejects a girl just for being different? I don't understand that. Where do you get these families?
Sally has been through so much already. She is a bright kid, full of promise.
Well, I'm sure she is. But finding her a home is your responsibility, not mine.
If you could just help.
I'll be happy to take a look at her file and assist you in any way I can. In 3 weeks.
I know it's early, but I wanted to make sure you'd be home.
What are you doing here?
Making one last plea for Sally.
Well, I've already explained.
Your Honor, in all good conscience, how can either of us complain about the system if we don't do everything in our power to change it? Just take a look. Get to know Sally a little. If you see what I see, you'll realize she deserves every break we can give her.
Fine.
Thank you, Judge. There's just a few pages. I didn't want to overload you with the whole case history.
I can't promise you anything.
Don't worry. I have faith enough for both of us.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Morning. A visiting hours don't start for another hour. You can wait over there if you like.
I'm Judge Catherine Woodbury.
Sorry, Judge. What can I do for you?
I sent a juvenile over yesterday, temporary custody.
Name?
Powell, Sally Ann.
Ward 3, Unit 221. But she's probably out in the yard now.
Can you take me?
You want to go back there?
Yes, I do.
I don't think that's such a good idea.
I would like to see the prison yard, Sergeant. Is that a problem?
No, ma'am. Your Honor, no problem at all.
I would think a stroll in this place would be an effective deterrent.
Work for my son. He was acting up, so I brought him down here for the night shift. Now it's straight A's every semester. The yard's just out here. Polly will take you out. He's looking for Powell, Sally Ann.
Thank you. What are you looking at?
Good question. What's the book?
It's How to Escape from Prison Manual.
Good sense of humor. That's important. It'll see you through a lot in life.
Sure done wonders for me so far.
Nice talking to you.
Already. She is a bright kid, full of promise.
Get something, Judge.
Hey, have you got a form 209A back there somewhere?
Yes, ma'am, I think so.
Get your California codes. Please read Welfare and Institutions, Section 385.
Any order by the court may at any time be modified or set aside as the presiding judge deems proper.
Now read Section 319.
The court may order the child to be placed in the approved home of a non-relative for a period not to exceed 30 judicial days.
Sign at the bottom, and would you please witness?
Court's releasing Sally Ann Powell to the custody of Catherine A. Woodbury?
Yes. Big house, you'll have your own room and bath, and I expect you to keep them both clean. You can come and go as you please, but there is a curfew. 10 on weekdays and 11 on weekends. I think that's reasonable.
Do you own this?
Yes.
And you live here all by yourself?
Uh-huh.
You're right. It's big. Don't you get scared?
Sometimes.
But you have a security system, right?
Oh, absolutely, and there's no reason for either of us to be nervous.
I'm not nervous.
Here, let me help you.
I'll do that.
Fine. The closet's here, and you have plenty of room in the chest of drawers. Your own TV.
How many channels you got?
150 at last count. Go ahead and unpack, and I'll go rustle up some lunch. Come to the kitchen when you're ready. You're in what, ninth grade?
10th.
Well, I guess there's no point in going to school. It's after 1.
I'm always up for a day off.
Yeah.
So what's this court recess?
Well, we close down for 3 weeks every year to catch up on appeals and petitions.
I get it. You babysit me for a while and then drop me off somewhere on your way back to work, right?
Here's the deal. There was no place to put you but jail or my house. So you'll stay with me until we can find you another foster family.
I think that's gonna happen. A four-time loser already.
I'm not saying it's gonna be easy.
Then why bother?
Because it beats the alternative.
In your opinion.
Boy, you are sure not out to win any popularity contests, are you?
I think I'll go keep my room clean.
I have a few errands to run. You want to come along?
I don't think so.
Can I trust you here alone?
I don't know. Can you?
That's why it's going to be fine. But as someone who stole a car last week, you might want to briefly consider the entire range of consequences that a judge can bring down on your underage head.
Fine. I won't run off. Besides, where would I go?
Fine. I'll see you later this evening. Miranda, I was just coming to see you.
Yeah, I just found out what you did for Sally. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Well, I'm going to need more than appreciation to get through this one.
Yeah, parenting isn't easy.
Well, I'm hardly her parent, but if I'm going to battle, I better be armed, so get me everything you've got on her.
Okay, I'm on break, so why don't we grab a cup of coffee? No message. I'll call him back, thanks. Wait. Yeah, hi. Just,
when you tell him I called, will you let him know I'm out? He'll understand. Thanks.
Four families in 5 years. That can't be normal.
Okay. It's not. A lot of foster children stick with one family. They connect with a parent or a sibling, but Sally never has.
Well, what about when she was younger? Didn't anyone want to adopt her?
Yeah, she came close when she was three, but the couple stopped the proceedings when the wife got pregnant. A few years later, another couple was interested, but then they split up.
Oh, what rotten luck.
Exactly. The second time, Sally was old enough to understand what was happening, and she took it pretty hard. It's when she started to shut down.
No wonder she's so tough. Don't you have anything that isn't a report or an evaluation? What about a paper she wrote for school?
No, that's it, except for sealed records, and I don't have access to them.
I do.
Nobody's done this much for Sally.
Well, right now, I'm her legal guardian.
Still here.
So I see. Your reader.
It's Miss Scape.
I know what you mean. When I was your age, I was never without a book.
What is it, David Copperfield?
One of my favorites.
Yeah, me too.
Well, I have school tomorrow. I should go to bed.
Good idea.
Night, Judge.
Please call me Kay.
All right, Kay.
Sleep well. Sally, I'm glad you're here.
This isn't really my field. I don't see many kids in my practice, and not a clinical evaluation. It's tough to say.
Well, there must be something there.
Well, no evidence of serious illness, I can tell you that.
What about the nightmares?
Well, she's got to have someone to talk to. Kids have vivid imaginations, and this one's hurt because she was abandoned.
The clothes, the attitude, the nightmares.
She's acting out because she's all alone in the world.
She's smart, Michael.
The test scores certainly indicate that. I mean, so does the behavior. Bright kids tend to overreach when they're up against the wall.
Why?
Because I think they know that they're missing something important.
If you like, I could set up an evaluation. That might be better.
Thanks. I'll think about it.
Morning.
Good morning. Sally, this is Dr. Katsu. He lives next door.
Hi, Sally.
I was just telling him that you'd be staying here for a while. The Katsus have a son, Danny, about your age.
We'll have to get you two together.
What kind of doctor are you?
I'm a psychiatrist.
So what do you think? Do we need to have her committed?
Very funny. We need to get you some breakfast. Thanks for the advice.
Not a problem.
In your office, there's some pictures of you with some old people. Are they your parents?
Old people? Whoa. My mother would love that.
So your mom's alive?
Alive and kicking. My father, too.
Do they live nearby?
About 45 minutes away.
What's that like, having parents?
Well, it's... it's wonderful, and it's... difficult, and it's very, very complicated.
What do you mean?
It means I love my mother and father very much, but sometimes it's hard to be around them.
Do they love you?
Too much, I think.
How can someone love you too much?
Trust me, it happens.
No one's ever loved me.
I bet you're wrong. I bet plenty of people love you.
Well, no one's ever said it to me.
Well, maybe they're afraid to say it.
Whatever. It doesn't really matter. I don't care.
Sally.
Yeah?
Do you remember anything about last night? It was very late, and I heard voices coming from your room, so I went to check on you.
I'm gonna be late for English, Carrie.
You were talking to someone.
Big deal. I was sleeping. It was a nightmare.
No, it wasn't like that. It was more like you were in a trance of some kind.
I was in a trance, and I was talking to someone. Who was I talking to?
Your mother.
I don't have a mother.
You were pleading with her. She wanted you to do something.
And why would I want to do something for my mother, huh? Why would I even want to talk to my mother, Kay?
Sally, please.
No, she abandoned me. She dumped me like I was garbage.
Sally, just... okay, let me just talk to you a minute.
Wake up, people. Who can tell me what's really going on here? Nobody eat breakfast? Come on, you guys. If all George and Martha ever wanted was to have a child, how could George just kill their son off? What is the playwright trying to say here? Did anyone read the play?
That George and Martha need marriage counseling?
Sally, help me out here.
They couldn't have children.
Sorry.
They couldn't have a family, so they made one up.
Good. That's right.
Don't forget, everybody, there's an essay due on Thursday, which means you have to read the play in order to write it. Enjoy your lunch.
So you want to cut class?
Duh.
Then again, mine's a terrible thing to waste.
That's what I hear. What are you doing here?
Looking for you. Where'd they dump you this time?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Who cares? You're out of jail.
And I have some good news. I got us the money.
What do you mean?
Getting out of here, going to San Francisco like we talked about. Now we can afford it.
How much you get?
You'll see.
Come on, Sal, how much?
I'll tell you after school. It's gonna be great. Home day.
Right.
Can I help you?
Yes, you can. I have something to sell.
These wouldn't be stolen, would they?
My grandmother gave them to me.
All right, if you say so.
James Powell and his wife had a little girl, and they moved into a house in Solvang. He was studying architecture, and she wanted to be a school teacher. When Sally was 9 months old, they were walking along Pacific Coast Highway. A drunk driver jumped the curb. James's back was broken in three places. His wife was killed. She was no older than you.
Are you 18?
I am.
I'd say, $200.
James tried to raise Sally for over a year by himself with a broken back. Put this letter in the file. To whom it may concern, I cannot give Sally what she deserves, and I want her to have the best life possible. Maybe we'll meet again when she is mature enough to forgive an old man for not measuring up when he was young. Until then, make sure she knows how much her dad loves her. Sincerely, James T. Powell, Jr.
Poor man.
Do you have any idea how important it would be for Sally to know that her dad cares?
Every child needs to know that.
$200.
I couldn't come up with anything on the mother. Her name appears on the birth certificate, but I can't read it.
Is it Margaret or Marjorie?
No telling. And it's the only place her name appears. It's not on any of the other forms.
Well, that's because she was already dead when the foster home proceedings began. Here's a cemetery plot. Mr. and Mrs. James T. Powell, Jr., Rose Hills Cemetery. It's right here in San Diego. Bet you find the mother there.
It's the dad who I'm interested in.
You think he's still around?
I've already checked the phone book and gone online, but there's no local listing. Next stop's the county clerk. I'm going to look for a business license. Maybe he opened up shop as an architect.
Maybe James Powell doesn't want to be reunited with his daughter. You ever think about that?
They're family. They belong together.
$200 is not nearly enough.
No, it's not. Take a little more. She's rich. She won't even miss it. This is our chance to get out. No more foster homes. No more people taking us in so they can get another government check. Come on, Sal. It's the only way we'll get out of here.
Here we go. What'd you say his first name was?
James.
James T. Junior?
Yes.
So what's the story? I'll just wait till I hear from you?
Don't push me, okay?
Sure, whenever you're ready. But sooner's better.
Yeah, who are you?
Danny Katsu.
The Shrinks kid?
Yeah, my dad told me about you.
Yeah, I'll bet. You go to Sunbriar?
Mm-hmm.
How come I've never seen you there?
Something tells me we run in different crowds.
So, what do you do for fun?
I got a chess set in the backyard.
Do the cops know?
Thank you.
your backyard, correct?
I think so, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I don't know. I thought just different colors.
Yellow. Yeah, you do such a good job.
That's a black Australian tree fern. Just pulled it off the truck this morning.
Oh, I don't need anything, really. I was just looking.
Well, if you have any questions, just let me know.
Well, actually, I do have a question. I need some work done at my house, some landscaping. Could you help me with that?
Absolutely. Why don't you step into my office and tell me about your property? Excuse the mess.
It's okay.
I've only been meaning to clean it up for about 10 years now. I'm Jim. I'm sorry. What's your name?
Woodbury. Catherine Woodbury.
Why does that sound familiar?
I'm a judge.
That's right. You're tough.
Only on the bad guys.
Well, I'll make sure I watch my stuff. Okay, so, what kind of place do you have, Judge?
Okay, please. I have a Spanish-style home in Coronado.
Oh, it's beautiful there. I do a lot of work in that area.
I thought maybe I could add some boxwoods along my property line.
Boxwoods are great. They grow kind of thick. You'd be walling yourself off from the rest of the world if that's what you want.
Maybe not.
Well, let's see if I got something to show you.
Checkmate.
Hey, you're pretty good. Don't take this the wrong way, but most girls don't really get chess.
What's that supposed to mean?
It's not the most feminine game. I mean, it seems to be more compelling to guys who like to smoke pipes.
One of my foster parents taught me. And for your information, he preferred generic cigarettes to a pipe.
How was that? Living in a foster home?
It's actually okay. Once you get used to it. Though you never do get comfortable. You never know when it's gonna be time to leave.
That must be hard.
Yeah. I guess, but you get by, you know? I sit here and dwell on how difficult my life is, but it really won't make any difference. So, you know, you just go with it. So, are you up for another game, or are you tired of losing to a girl?
Bring it on.
You're going down.
I'll call you in a day or two. I just need a little time to picture all the changes.
No problem. You take your time.
Thank you for your help. I like your ideas very much.
Okay, see you later.
You betcha.
There's something you need to see.
They've played four games. She's won three. Danny's the president of the chess club, and she beat him.
I stayed awfully late at the Katsus last night.
Danny said I couldn't leave till he beat me two games in a row. I finally had to let him win.
How would you like to be my date to a party tonight?
What kind of party?
It's a nice one. You'll need a new dress.
I don't have any dresses.
That's okay. We'll go shopping. Is this what you're looking for?
You went through my stuff?
It was sticking out, staring at me. I don't know under what circumstances that came off, but you can probably imagine how I might feel about that sort of thing.
And I bet you're gonna tell me, aren't you?
It's your body, Sally. You're a big girl, and I'm not your mother. All actions have consequences, you know?
Yeah, I get it, okay?
Oh, my God.
What?
It's nothing. It's nobody.
Nobody rang the bell.
You're so nervous. Wouldn't be a guy by any chance, would it?
Yeah, as a matter of fact.
Good morning.
Morning.
I know it's early, but I thought I'd come by, take a look at your backyard, and try and come up with some ideas.
Sure. No problem. Come on in.
Thank you.
Sally, this is Jim. He's going to be doing some landscaping work for me.
Sally. I've always loved that name.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too, I guess.
So how many children do you have?
Well, Sally's not my daughter. She's a friend.
Kay doesn't have any children. She's single.
Divorced, actually.
I'm just going to be out back taking some measurements, if that's okay.
Oh, sure. Take as long as you'd like. Sally and I were just going shopping.
You guys have a good time.
Kay has a boyfriend.
Shut up, I do not. What do you think? What do you think?
Ew.
What?
Come on, Kay. I'm only 16. I'm not ready to look like you yet. Let's go over there. So, what do you think?
It's party, Sally, not a rock concert.
Go ahead. Try it on.
Oh, no, thank you. I don't think it's me.
It's an original Maldoni. My boyfriend gave me one for Christmas.
Okay.
How about this one? Can't keep them in stock.
Ah. I like it. Perfect.
They're gonna love that down at the courthouse. No, don't. It looks good.
Really?
Yeah, you should get it.
No.
Come on, Kay. When was the last time you bought yourself something fun? Yeah, you actually look kind of cool in that jacket.
Thanks, I think.
What?
Well, are you saying that I wasn't cool before the jacket? Well, what?
No, you look more relaxed. It's a good thing.
Thank you, then. Excuse me. Hello? Hi, Mom. No, I'm shopping. It's okay. You guys are working this from every angle, aren't you? Please, don't start with me. Okay, I'll tell Davis that Dad isn't feeling well. Bye. Can't believe it.
What?
My ex-husband invited my parents to his party tonight.
So?
Well, he knows that my dad and I aren't speaking.
Well, why aren't you speaking to your dad?
It's a long story.
Come on.
6 months ago, his firm filed a wrongful death suit against the power company. Some problems developed, and they needed time to redirect the case. So he approached me ex parte, that means outside the courtroom, and asked me for a favor, a delay.
And did you give it to him?
I told him if he ever approached me again, I'd report him to the California Bar Association. What he asked for was inappropriate, unethical, and illegal.
One little favor?
This wasn't just a mistake, it was a crime.
Did he apologize?
He tried to.
Did anyone get hurt?
No.
Well, then forget it. He's your dad.
It's not that simple.
Sure it is. You'd rather be right than be with your parents. You've got your priorities all screwed up.
My priorities? Fine.
Come on. Being right all the time gets lonely. Admit it.
I do not have to be right all the time.
You mean like now? Cut people some slack. You take this judge thing way too seriously.
Sally, do you
know much about your birth parents?
No, and I don't want to.
Well, aren't you just a little bit curious?
I don't want to talk about this, okay? I told you that before.
Well, there may be more to the story than you know. Maybe your mom and dad hated to give you up. Maybe they didn't have any other choice.
I mean it.
All right, look, I won't bring it up again, I promise. I'm sorry.
I want to do my own hair.
Yeah, we should get ready. What do you think?
You're gonna wear that?
Basic black, it's classic.
Yeah, but you wear black like every day to work. Don't you have anything jazzier?
Jazzy is not my style.
Come on, Carrie. This is your ex-husband's party. You have to look hot.
Wait a minute. I haven't accessorized yet. That's odd. I could have sworn I put my grandmother's brooch in here.
Yeah, well, you don't want to wear anything your grandmother gave. You know, you need something flashy. Trust me, that dress needs it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get ready myself.
You look gorgeous. No, I mean it, Sally. You're a beautiful young woman.
Checking in, I hadn't heard from you yet. Man, that dress,
you
it's...
You have to go.
Why, where are you off to?
I'll tell you later, please just go.
Did you get us more stuff?
Just get out of here, please.
What is your problem? What happens next week or next month when she gets tired of you and you end up in another foster home?
God, I can't believe it.
I'm the one who's been with you through all these years.
What are you doing? Stop it. Are you all right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Who is that creep?
Just a friend.
Sally Powell. Sally, this is...
Davis Woodbury, her honor's favorite ex-husband.
It's nice.
Oh, no, no, not at all. Kay, I'd like you to meet the future Mrs. Davis Woodbury.
Monica Tejada. It's a real pleasure to meet you, Judge Woodbury.
Call me Kay, please.
I want to thank you so much for coming tonight. I know it means an awful lot to Davis.
In the meantime, if you need any tips on how to handle Davis, I kept extensive notes.
Oh, well, I've kept quite a diary going myself.
He's a handful, that's for sure. But hang in there. He's worth it.
I'm sorry.
So sorry.
Don't worry about it. It's all right.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You're not fine at all, Sally.
How do you know my name?
I know quite a bit about you.
Are you a friend of Kay's?
I like Kay very much. She's a good person. You're a good person too, Sally.
No, I'm not. I took something that wasn't mine. It belonged to Kay.
Sally, look at me. You are a kind and wonderful person. You're just afraid, and there's no reason to be afraid.
I know who you are.
I'm someone who cares about you very much.
I don't believe it. You're here.
I've always been with you, you know that.
But now I can see you. Everything's gonna be better now, isn't it? Everything's gonna change.
You're right. Everything will change. And everything will get better if you let it. But you have to open your heart, Sally. You have to learn to forgive. Because if you trust and forgive, you will be happy.
Stay here with me.
I will never leave you. I promise. I promise.
Sally? Who were you talking to?
She was just right here.
Are you all right?
I'm a little dizzy.
Yeah, I can smell how dizzy you are. Let's go. Let me help you. Hello?
Kay, thank God.
Mom, what is it? What's wrong?
I'm at the hospital with your father. He's had a heart attack.
I'm on my way.
Catherine, good.
How is it?
We don't know yet. We're waiting for the test results. Honey, who is that?
Sally.
Who?
She's a foster child.
Whose foster child?
Mine. When do we get the test results?
The doctor says we might have to wait a couple of hours.
Must be sick if you're here.
You stop that. You're gonna be perfectly fine.
Is that your diagnosis or the doctor?
Just rest.
Susie.
Please, that's all you have to do. Just rest.
Thanks for coming, Katie girl. Are you still angry with me?
Come on, Dad.
Kate. I made a mistake, but I never meant to hurt you. I just didn't think. I'll make it up to you. I love you, Katie.
Just rest, okay? And we'll talk about all of this later, I promise. And tell you what, we'll go to dinner, just the two of us. Go to that Italian restaurant that you love.
Manzanetti's.
That's it. You and I will have dinner at Manzanetti's. My treat.
And we'll talk.
We'll close the joint. Just rest, okay? It's gonna be okay.
We've given him all the usual tests and everything's fine. But just in case, we'd like to keep him here for observation.
Observation?
We just want to be on the safe side. But really, you have nothing to worry about. Your father's as strong as an ox. He isn't going anywhere.
Is there anything we need to be doing?
Yes. You should go home and get some rest.
Thank you, Doctor.
Don't let him do too much too fast. You know how he gets.
Don't worry, I'll take care of him. What are you going to do about this one?
I'm not sure. I think she stole Graham's brooch.
What?
It's not where I put it, and there's some other things missing, too.
Have you confronted her?
No, not yet.
Honey, are you sure you really want to do this?
I don't know. I don't know what I want to do at this point. Mom, I'm sorry I stayed angry for so long.
Don't apologize.
No, I shouldn't have been so pig-headed about it.
You're here now. That's all that matters.
You're right.
I'm always right.
Do you have any aspirin?
The cabinet by the stove. I didn't expect to see you upright so soon.
I promised Danny Katsu I'd go roller skating with him.
How do you feel?
Sick to my stomach with a killer headache.
Good.
I screwed up, didn't I?
Yep, you did.
I'm sorry. I guess I was just nervous.
Well, at least you learned a lesson.
Morning. Ready to roll?
In a sec.
Are you sure you're up to this?
I could use the fresh air.
Call me if you're going to be late.
Thanks. Bye.
See you later.
Jim.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm guessing you didn't get my message. I just said I'd stop by with some drawings today.
I'm sorry. Things have been kind of hectic, and I haven't even checked my machine.
Oh, well, we can do this another time.
No. Come on in. It's fine. Would you like some coffee or something?
Oh, no. Thank you. I'm okay. I mean, if this isn't a good time, I can come back.
No, I'm just tired. I was at the hospital all night. My father's ill.
Well, I hope he's okay.
Yeah, he's holding his own. You know what? I'm glad you're here.
How did you get into landscaping?
Actually, I wanted to be an architect.
but I had an accident and I had to leave school. Well, I had this buddy that was starting a landscaping project and I just fell in love with it. You know, it's like life. You nurture some things, you ignore the others. It's all about choices, right?
You know, it's funny you say that about choices, because I made a big one recently and it's really turned out great. You know Sally?
Yeah, the girl that's living with you, right?
Well, actually, she's a foster child, and she's really smart and terrific. Which isn't to say that she doesn't have her problems, because we all do. You know, I'm rambling, I'm sorry. But the poor kid's really been through a lot, kind of kicked from pillar to post. She's never known what it's like to have a real family.
That's a shame.
Yeah, it is, because there's something really special about her. Before I met her, I thought I had the answer to everything. But she's made me question myself, and I think that's good.
Definitely. Okay, here we go.
I give up. I'm tired and confused, and I don't know any other way to do this but just tell you.
Tell me what, Ken?
Sally's not just a foster child. She's your daughter.
What?
It's true. She's your little girl. She had no place to go, so I took her in, and then I found out that you were her father. I'm sorry. I know this must be a shock.
Does she know? Does she know who I am?
No, she has no idea.
Oh, I have to go.
Okay. I'm serious. You did really well for a beginner.
Thanks. It was fun.
Yeah. It was. So, you want to play chess a little later?
Sure.
I'm back in one piece.
You must have been curious. You must have thought about her.
Of course I thought about her.
Well, then why didn't you try to find her?
Because it doesn't matter. She already hates me.
How could she hate you? She doesn't even know you.
Hey, what do you want me to do? March in there with 16 years worth of birthday presents and beg for forgiveness?
Of course not.
Look, I failed her. Okay, I gave up my own flesh and blood because I was scared and weak.
No one's judging you.
Look, I don't care what anybody else thinks about me. I know what I did was wrong.
Give her a chance. Sally's a terrific kid. You'll be proud of her, I know.
You just don't get it, do you?
Yes, I do. I know you made a mistake, but you're lucky because you have a chance to correct it. Jim, you have a remarkable daughter who needs a father. She deserves a second chance, and so do you.
What must she think of me?
Oh my God. You liar.
I can't do it, Kay. I can't fix what's wrong with her. I mean, I wouldn't know where to start.
What's wrong with her is she doesn't have a dad like you to talk
Look,
to.
It's too late, okay? Too much has happened.
She's your daughter. She's your responsibility.
You had no right.
going on? Why do you want to meet me here?
San Francisco, open your golden gates.
Let's just get out of here now.
You stay here. You're a minor, remember?
Let you know as soon as we hear anything. If you give me your cell phone number, then I'll call you right away.
Kay.
Excuse me. Oh, thank God. Are you all right? He didn't hurt you.
No. But he took all the money from your jewelry.
Oh. Forget the jewelry. It's okay.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
No, it's not. I stole your stuff.
You stole it because you were angry with me, and you had every right to be. What I did was wrong. I should have told you about your father. I'm so sorry, Sally.
He left, didn't he?
He's scared. People run when they're scared.
Do you think he's gonna be back?
I don't know.
Pardon me, Judge. Is everything okay here?
Yeah.
She's fine, officer. Thank you.
I'll need to talk to you when you're done.
Am I going back to jail?
Oh, don't worry about it. We'll take care of it.
Thank you. What's wrong with me, Kay?
There's nothing wrong with you.
Yes, there is.
No, there's not.
No matter where I go or what I do, I always end up alone. I don't fit in anywhere.
That's not true. You fit just perfectly right here.
Thank you.
You're coming, aren't you?
You sure?
Absolutely. She'll want to see you too. Sooner, but now that I know where you are, I'll come a lot more often. I promise. I'm doing a lot better, just like you said I would. And Kate's taking really good care of me. I think about you all the time, Mom.
It's okay.